Dr. Smita, uterine fibroids are becoming very common in so many women and are often a cause of infertility and even miscarriage.
Miscarriage, yeah.
In India, one in four women have fibroids and these benign non-cancerous tumours that grow either within or outside the uterine lining. Mm. I have a patient in Australia. She was in the Sydney clinic and she came to see you, Dr. Naram, for treatment also, which I followed up with her subsequently. Yeah. She presented with a 13-centimetre fibroid.
Wow.
Allopathy Allopathy wished her to go for surgery, of course, which is so common.
Yes.
And she chose not to. Mm. And she followed the treatment with herbs and diet alone.
I remember.
And in 3 years, fibroid was completely gone.
She was really completely surprised. I remember she had one surgery as well to remove the fibroid first, and then it grew back again. And then she came and she said, "Oh my God, I'm just 32 and I need to get rid of this because I need to get a child in the future."
So surgery is not always the solution to the cause of the problem because, of course, the fibroid can grow back again.
Yeah.
And it can create other complications, including adhesions, scar tissues, which create further infertility issues.
Yes.
So, Dr. Smita, how does Ayushakti treat fibroids?
Yeah, basically, Dipika, Ayushakti basically looks at fibroid from rasa and mansa dhatu perspective. Because as I told you that when you eat food, you know, that the nutritional plasma, which is absorbed in the blood, is really converted into different tissues in a very cyclic organized manner, you know. And the first one which is nourished is rasa dhatu in this cycle of tissue system, and then blood and muscle tissue. Now, when the ras is not nourished in a right manner, or it's overly nourished, you know, over estrogens are produced, and then impact of that, you know, even mamsa dhatu is then stimulated and overly nourished, and it produces fibroids in the body, especially in the uterus, you know, and female, they get fibroids just because of this metabolic imbalance and hormonal imbalance.
So in addition to surgery being recommended to remove uterine fibroids, there's also arterial embolism is one procedure that's now commonly prescribed by allopathic doctors.
Yeah.
I had a patient in Sydney who, we were working for several years with her fibroids and they were reducing slowly.
Mm.
And the treatment, the Ayushakti treatment, was also addressing other menopausal symptoms beautifully.
Yeah.
But the fibroids were reducing a little too slowly and she went for arterial embolism.
Yeah.
And it was not the solution because her body went into shock.
Oh, really?
After this procedure.
Yeah.
And it took a long time for her to convalesce and recover.
Mm.
So,
yeah, it's said that sometimes people get this kind of a shock and then infection. They remain weak and ill for months and months after arterial embolism.
Yes.
And anyways, you stop blood supply in one fibroid through this to shrink it, but it will grow in another area.
Mm-hmm.
So it has to be balanced Ayurvedically from inside. That's what is necessary.
Correct.
Yeah.
And so what is the treatment for fibroids?
Yeah, basically we do infertox treatment, specially designed and focused only on fibroid, diet, lifestyle, and marma and home remedies. That's what we do.
Yeah, and what is infertox treatment for fibroids specifically?
Yeah, so as I told you, that fibroid is really imbalance of rasa and mamsa dhatu. As per Ayurveda, overly nourished rasa and mamsa dhatu. Coming back to connecting that to modern expressions, estrogen imbalance and overly grown muscle tissue. Mamsa dhatu imbalance is overly grown muscle tissue. So that's how it is, and we specifically focus on removing the blockage in metabolic system and hormone system so that nothing is overly nourished and everything comes back to normal, so that slowly and steadily the muscles tissue which is overly grown begins to shrink naturally.
Yes.
That's important. But the most important part is that female, because Ayurveda reduces fibroids very slowly, as you know.
Yes.
You know, Chiyomi also took process. Like 3 years yes. for that 12 centimeter fibroid size. And that's precisely how it works anyways. But the beautiful thing for Infertox is that, you know what, even if fibroids reduce a little bit, they get pregnant fast.
Because the channels are open.
Channels are opened and the uterus is really more flexible
yes.
and very soft.
Wonderful.
And so we do, basically first part is always removing the blockages and anti-clog treatments, focused on rasa and mamsadhatu system particularly, hormones and muscle tissue particularly. So we do a specific massage and anti-clog type of siddha massages, which is stimulating body to liquidate and move out all the toxins which are blocking the process of normal balancing in the body. So once that is liquidated, then through a specific massage and warm treatments and oil, we move them from the different parts of the body to the digestive tract. And then through purgation, we expel this whole mucousy heavy toxins out of the body. People literally see mucus yellow and grayish mucus passing through, and after that they feel light. And then we start giving specific enema treatments, which is again what we call is bhedan bastis, which means it is more not nourishing type but more reducing muscle tissue type bastis. Those enemas we do it like almost 16. End of that, already the fibroids shrink very much. In fact, after this treatment, normally around 2 to 3 centimeter shrink comes. And then we continue the herbs, which is suride for balancing metabolism and hormones naturally. As I told you, it's not any chemical, but it's all natural.
Yes.
It helps our own body to function in the right manner. So people who have high estrogen, it comes down and balances.
And which Ayushakti herbs are used specifically in fibroid treatment?
Yeah, after the Infertox is finished, then we start with the herbs, which has suride, which is natural balance of our own hormones. And that way, you know, excess estrogen reduces slowly, slowly, and fibroid shrink because of that. And then uritone, which is for removing all the water retention, because besides fibroid, they also have a lot of water retention, bloated around the tummy areas, you know, and thighs and everything. And uritone, when taken in high dose, it removes all the water retention, and that is the reason precisely, in spite of having fibroids, people conceive and have a very natural full-term pregnancy, because all these blockages and excess load is gone.
It's amazing.
Then granthihar, which is, granthihar means reducing the tumor, granthi is tumor. So that, as per Sanskrit, you know.
Yes.
Tumors. So it reduces, literally the herbs slowly and steadily reduces all the tumors everywhere in the body. It can be lipoma, it can be fibroids, it reduces cyst, fibroid, everything, all the tumors in the body. So that we give also for a long time, and slowly, slowly keeps reducing the fibroid over a period of months and months.
Very good. Yeah. Very good. And home remedies, is there any specific home remedy?
Yes, if somebody can't come and see us, because you live in Australia and I'm in India, they can follow diet in this home remedy, which has 1 teaspoon of fennel seed powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin seed powder, 1/4 teaspoon of ajwain, which is known as wild celery seed in English, 1/4 teaspoon of ajwain powder, a pinch of asafoetida, 1 teaspoon of Ayurvedic herb whose name is Bharangi, and 1 teaspoon of another Ayurvedic herbs whose name is Punarnava. These combined together in 1/2 glass of water and drank 2 or 3 times a day. This also helps reducing fibroid very slowly and steadily.
Wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful. Thank you, Dr. Smita.
Yeah.
What specific lifestyle is recommended with fibroids?
Yeah. When we have fibroid, women, which now the percentage is growing, 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 it is important to exercise a lot. Run, swim, at least half an hour a day.
Mm.
Then yoga is very important, especially yoga mudra, paryankasana, halasana, sarvangasana. These are the asanas which are very effective for fibroids, and V-split, if somebody can do it, this is very fantastic. I have personally seen that they stabilize them very well, and people get rid of the symptoms of fibroids as well.
Yes, of course. Yeah. Wonderful.
Yeah.
Thank you, Dr. Smita.
Great. Lovely.